Fuck You, Cancer by Deborah James. Read by Deborah James. For Hugo and Eloise, no time to turn at Beatty's glance and watch her feet, how they dance. A poor life this is if, full of care, we have no time to stand and stare. William Henry Davies. Chapter 1. It was 6 p.m. on an idle Thursday. My name is Deborah, and I'm not an alcoholic. I, too, was surprised that the cancer came first. I've had a few of those moments of blindsided panic in my life, but of all my obsessive compulsive fears, I never thought this one would be my reality. It feels cliché to write, but the day I was diagnosed with cancer is the day my world stopped still. Perhaps you are reading this because yours has too. Life as I knew it would never be the same. And if you have joined the Cancer Club, a club you never wanted to be part of, be prepared for a bumpy ride. I'm not going to lie. No one ever said it was going to be easy, and it isn't. But I hope to share with you some golden nuggets of advice and top tips from the front line. Some say there is a power in three. The romantic in us goes weak when presented with "I love you," is humbled by "I forgive you," and scared to the point of no return when hearing "you have cancer." You may feel right now that your worst fear has lifted off a page and been brought to life, and you might not know how to put one foot in front of the other, let alone get your head around the idea of surgery or chemo. And I have been there. Hell, I'm there right now, writing this, not knowing what my next plan of action is, or what pesky lung tumours are deciding to do. But the point is, I'm still here, with wine and high heels, shouting, "Fuck you, cancer," as loud as I can, as I prepare for yet another lung operation. It's not easy, and I don't know what my future holds. But I do know that when the big C enters, you can, with the right mindset, face it, live your life, and still be yourself. So I've written this book to help you navigate the cancer rollercoaster, in the knowledge that you are not alone. That it's okay to have good days, bad days, and everything in between. And that all those feelings you're experiencing are part of the ride, however crazy they may seem. But I'm going to give you a spoiler. I'm sorry to disappoint, but I don't know a cure for cancer. I can't tell you if eating turmeric will help you, or doing 20 handstands a day will provide a cure. Trust me, I wish I knew. But this is what I can tell you. I am an average 36-year-old married mum of two. I was ploughing through life as a deputy head teacher, doing the 12-hour working days, trying to juggle kids, husband, friends, keeping fit, having a laugh, and getting some sleep. I was on autopilot. My career took precedence. My relationships came last. Dinner on the table would be considered a miracle, and my kids gazed in disbelief if I ever actually turned up for something. I enjoyed the things many 30-somethings do. Wine, clothes, gossip, sex. I complained about lack of shut-eye, worried I wasn't making it in my job, and was just about navigating the trials and tribulations that two crazy kids and a full-time high-pressured job puts on any marriage. And then everything changed. On an idle Thursday, the week before Christmas, my worst nightmare became a reality. As I stared at my 6.5-centimetre tumour during a colonoscopy, never did I realise more that the life I had been taking for granted would be the one thing that I now desired above all else. When I was diagnosed with bowel cancer, something only normally considered a possibility over the age of 60, my world spun out of control. As all cancer patients are, I was left to deal with a new life, one where my daily goal was to live, to get up and fight cancer. But I'm human. You can't jump from a regular life to one of just trying to keep your head above the water without feeling like you are drowning at times. I had an outpouring of love, support and well wishes, but I was fighting to stay afloat. I had to find my own way through and find an element of control on an unpredictable ride, especially as the goalposts kept changing. And you will have to as well. You may meet lots of people who will tell you that remaining positive, cutting sugar, eating a raw food diet, or paying hundreds of thousands of pounds for an unproven nutrient drip will rid you of the beast that is cancer. You can beat it, they'll declare, as you kindly hand over your hard-earned pennies in a quest for the holy grail of medicine. And perhaps it will work for you. I'm not a doctor or a researcher, and I'm not going to pretend I'm an expert in the field. Because, quite frankly, I've met people who are, and I feel totally humbled in their presence. I've seen scientists kill breast cancer cells under the microscope with chemotherapy, which I took great pleasure in watching. But I've also listened to the brightest brains in the industry talk about just how clever even one little cell can be. If it wants to outsmart me or you, it will. It doesn't matter how big or strong or ugly we are. Doctors are, however, doing incredible things. And because of research, funding, technology, and brilliant minds, today more people are living for 10 years after the big C enters their life than will die from it. But we are not there yet. We don't have a magic cure for cancer. But advances do mean that I've undergone procedures that a few years ago would not have even been considered. It means I have a chance, and so do you. And with the right outlook, you too can take control of a situation that might seem hopeless. A cancer diagnosis isn't always game over, regardless of what the statistics might tell you. I was diagnosed with a cancer where stats told me only 34% of women make it through the first year. Imagine celebrating a new year where you had a greater chance of dying than surviving. If I live to see my 5-year cancer anniversary and my 40th birthday, I will be one of only 9% who do. But I'm not beating cancer. I'm just learning to live with it and navigating through the minefield it presents. I haven't done anything special that means I'm alive to write this today. And I pray for the sake of my kids that I can kick this can as far down the road as possible. But do I think I will make it? Will I be there with fireworks, shouting, "Fuck you, cancer," at my big 40? Honestly, I'm not sure. While I believe in miracles, they work both ways, right? Hell, I'm the marathon-running, vegetarian for 25 years, young woman who got the meat-eating, overweight, old man cancer. As such, while someone is living with cancer, I'm not convinced you have control beyond your mind and the way you deal with each challenge presented. That's why I created a character who was way cooler than me. Bowel Babe.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.